May I now request the Honorable Prime Minister, Dr. Manmohan Singh, to kindly address the distinguished gathering.
Respected Rashtrapati ji, respected Chairperson of the Indira Gandhi Memorial Trust, Srimati Sonia Gandhi ji, members of the jury, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, it's a privilege to be present here on the occasion of the conferment of the prestigious Indira Gandhi Prize for Peace, Disarmament and Development for 2011 on Padma Bhushan Srimati Ila Ramesh Bhatt. Such public recognition of her work is not new to Ila Ben. She has been a deserving recipient of accolades around the world for her pioneering efforts in the area of women's emancipation and empowerment. Indeed, her life's work is best described in her own words. While receiving the Nivano Peace Prize for 2010 in Tokyo, Ila Ben had said that her story and philosophy could be expressed in three simple words: women, work, and peace. The sheer simplicity and relevance of this conceptual framework, combined with her remarkable work ethic, is largely responsible for the force that Ila Ben represents when it comes to giving a voice to the concern of India's women. The prize that Ila Ben is being honored with today is, of course, named after another very remarkable woman, Srimati Indira Gandhi. Srimati Indira Gandhi worked and fought relentlessly for the elimination of poverty and empowerment of women. Her clarion call, Garibi Hatao, remains relevant more than four decades after it was first given. While deliberating on the work of Ila Ben, I was struck by the similar idea of combating poverty that seems to be her motive force. By saying that poverty is the moral failure of a society, Ila Ben throws down the gauntlet to society at large. Her own attempt to attack poverty by organizing poor women and helping them empower themselves economically is at once aimed at the twin evils of poverty and gender discrimination. Mahatma Gandhi's ideas on Swaraj, I believe, have been Ila Ben's touchstones as she set out on her journey to form the Self-Employed Women's Association and build it into one of India's most respected and effective social enterprises. While the Mahatma succeeded in bringing political freedom to India, he did not live to see the vital counterpart, economic freedom, being realized in any substantial measure. Therefore, when Ila Ben says to her colleagues in Seva, "My sister, Swaraj is ours to take," she is in many ways carrying on the unfinished work of Mahatma Gandhi in the area of winning economic freedoms and self-reliance for India's women, who constitute about half of India's population. The sexual harassment of women at workplace, Prevention, Prohibition and Redressal Bill 2012 has been passed by the Lok Sabha and is awaiting passage in the Rajya Sabha. Schemes aimed at giving restorative justice to victims of rape through financial assistance and support services a national helpline for women, and a one-stop crisis center in 100 public hospitals under the aegis of the National Mission for Empowerment of Women are also under consideration of the government. Our endeavor to create an environment of security in which women can pursue their dreams will be a continuous effort pursued jointly with civil society organizations. Ladies and gentlemen, the story of Ilaben and Seva is not just a story of organizing poor women for economic empowerment. It is also the story of women's right and protection of women. It is the story of holistic empowerment of the poor for ensuring them equality and rights guaranteed under the Constitution, for ensuring timely delivery of entitlements, and for countering all forms of discrimination. Above all, it is a story of leadership. Ilaben, whom some have called the gentle revolutionist, has demonstrated that struggle and constructive work can go together. These are her great contributions to the discipline of development. They deserve not only to be acknowledged, but also to be deeply analyzed and studied for rapid and widespread replication. By honoring her today, we do credit to the principle that this country holds dear. I congratulate her on her achievements and hope and pray that others will follow in her footsteps and make our country a better place to live in. Thank you. Jai Hind.
इंदिरा गांधी स्मारक न्यास का अंतर्राष्ट्रीय निर्णायक मंडल व्यापक जमीनी स्तर पर उद्यमिता, आश्रय की उपलब्धता, स्वास्थ्य, सूक्ष्म वित्त, सूक्ष्म बीमा, कार्यकुशलता, कानूनी सेवाओं, सामूहिक मोल भाव की शक्ति और कई अन्य माध्यमों से भारत एवं अन्य जगहों पर महिलाओं को सशक्त बनाने और इस तरह सामान्य विकास और शांति को बढ़ावा देने, आत्मनिर्भरता और अहिंसा के गांधीवादी मार्ग का अनुसरण करने की जीवन भर की उपलब्धियों के लिए श्रीमती ईला रमेश भट्ट को शांति, निरस्त्रीकरण और विकास के लिए वर्ष 2011 का इंदिरा गांधी पुरस्कार प्रदान करता है। The International Jury of the Indira Gandhi Memorial Trust has awarded the 2011 Indira Gandhi Prize for Peace, Disarmament and Development to Srimati Ila Ramesh Bhatt for her lifetime achievements in comprehensively empowering women in India and elsewhere through grassroots entrepreneurship, access to shelter, healthcare, microfinance, microinsurance, skills, legal services, collective bargaining power and other means, thereby promoting equitable development and peace following the Gandhian path of self-reliance and non-violence. May I request the Honorable President of India, Shri Pranab Mukherjee, to kindly present the award to Srimati Ila Ramesh Bhatt.